Hello guys, welcome to Badass Cult. Here we speak about tough and uncompromising things. This video basically it's about recently launched Samsung's Galaxy Z Fold 2. So we know that people, not just people, like many companies, they are like craving to get a foldable phone which is a fit and it would be a commercial success. So this phone is such an attempt. So here Samsung, it's basically trying to get a commercially successful foldable phone. Okay, so speaking about this design, the phone's design, it's good, maybe it's not good, probably. If you look at the design, this phone got two displays. So a foldable display which is inside, they call it as a, like a tablet, a bigger display. On the outside you have an other display which is a normal display. Again here, so the foldable display inside, like where you have a folded display inside this phone, this display is a super good display, that is very good display. It ticks up all the marks, like the display specifications. And this display, it supports the HDR 10+, and even the refresh rate, it is 120Hz. So it's a good display on the outside, on the car display, that's also a good display. It's a Super AMOLED display, and that's great. There is no questions in the department of displays with Samsung, since they make fucking awesome displays, and those are incredible. So I got no concerns with the displays. But the major concern over here, it's with the design. So why I'm saying it's a concern? So let's pick some facts. Like this phone got two different displays and the camera setups. Like you have a primary camera setup which is a triple camera setup. Like how you have a 12 megapixel wide angle, 12 megapixel ultra wide angle, 12 megapixel telephoto lens. So all those cameras, those are really good. Like if someone, they are trying to pick this mobile, what they'll do? Like what are the core features they expect? They expect a good photography in such a mobile, right? But in this mobile, it's good. But speaking about the front camera, like if this design is like some design like where you have in Huawei Mate X, where the front camera and the rear camera, it's the same thing. You'll have one primary camera and like one primary camera setup where you experience it for everything. But here I think they are making some confusion, not just confusion, but like this design is not good in such things. You know why? Because they got an extra display. But whereas in case of such a display where you have one single foldable display, but here two different displays, one foldable display and a car display. And I think that makes more money into building up, right? And again, so to produce such a mobile, it costs more. And I think they are making such a mistake again. So this is a second series, right, of this Fold, Z Fold 2. It is a Z Fold 2 mobile. And I think so, that is a concerning thing. Why? Because it's not a thing. Like if there is a single display also, it works. And a best part would be like there will be elimination of two selfie cameras. Here they are using two selfie cameras. Those will be eliminated. What will you have in addition? So you'll be using the camera which is over here, like a primary camera setup, will be using as a selfie camera. Even it is for the rear camera, like you wanted to capture any videos, all that. So that would be a great option if design is such a thing. So here it's a concerning factor, but yeah, and Samsung is not making such a design. So we have to rely on Samsung. And like if somebody who is into this fancy stuff and they wanted to have such a foldable phone, they probably choose Samsung over Huawei. Why? It's because they are the one, like they make good Android phones and their phones are optimized well, like with camera integration, with software, camera integration, everything. Like basically Samsung has a big Android market. So if they are coming up with a good design like a Huawei Mate X, so it would probably get success, I think so. And we know the Samsung Galaxy Fold, I think it is priced around 1.7 lakhs. So that much amount is a big deal. But if somebody is gonna spend such a big amount of money, they would expect a better design, right? So basically, this stuff is fancy, it's overpriced. If it is not at for sale, if it is for sale also, it would be overpriced, I think so. So that is gonna happen. So, but on the bottom line, I appreciate Samsung's work to get some foldable phone, because foldable phone will create an impact. I also believe it will create a little impact, and I will definitely believe that this phone is not gonna make us one big category. Maybe this will create a certain certain portion, this will definitely not eliminate the whole phone segment itself. Like now how we have a just one flat display market, I think this won't eliminate, but yeah, maybe this may create a small category where you'll have a like a hybrid tablet come mobile thing, maybe which is foldable. If they are trying to make a cheap and cost effective phone, maybe it will be a big success in our market, not just in market, an average consumer also could get such a mobile. And speaking about different things, we have to speak about battery also, right? So battery is an important thing, and we should always consider the battery specifications in any mobile. So in this mobile and this, what to call, I don't know, it's a mobile or a tablet also, what to call, because it's like a heap, it's very thick, right? This mobile is super thick, so, and it also, the weight also little more than an ordinary phone. Again, you have to remember this is having a battery of 4500 mAh, so which is a good amount. It is decent good, but it is not the best or the super best, since we know Samsung itself is gonna launch a 7000 mAh battery phones, which is M41 or M51 series. So those batteries will long laster, and so those phones will long last also, they know. But so to bring such a design with less weight, so it costs them, and again packing such a battery, it will definitely add up more weight, right? Maybe that might be the reason. So but yeah, I appreciate their efforts. So nextly, speaking about these specifications, like the ordinary specifications, but those are important to consider, right? The performance and the storage department. So, and no doubts about it, this phone will definitely check those performance. You'll be mostly you'll be having a top end Samsung Exynos processor or a top end Snapdragon processor, that is for sure. So that is it. Or and in addition to that, your storage department, it will definitely check. You'll be having 12 gigs of RAM, so which is super good, so it's super more also again. So that is well, if you, enough. And next, the storage. So Samsung, we know Samsung, they give a lot of storage, and at such a flagship mobiles. So I think it will be 256 gigs and 512 GB options. You'll be having two different options. So this phone will not create any problems with all those things. And one thing, what is that? We have to remember, if somebody is they are a tech enthusiast, and they are super interested in such a new upcoming tech, and they wanted to try them up, and they are gonna investing such a big amount of money, take a case, it may be around 1.5 lakhs, maybe it will be definitely more than that. So if somebody is investing in such a stuff, such a fancy stuff, and here there are issues with design only. So it's with design, and we know that Samsung's Fold display, when first one launched, it got some issues, and they released it eventually with solving them. And again, so it's not a factor, but yeah, so it's on the line, right? So the curve is just starting up. So on the starting curve, so they will be having some problems, and I think Samsung should consider this thing, replacing like recreating their design with only one foldable display, like a Huawei Mate X. So where you'll having a fantastic camera, like for your selfie camera and the rear camera. So I think that would be a great option. So guys, what do you think about this, like Samsung's move towards foldable things? What do you think? Comment that down. Nextly, if you loved watching this video, please do like it. At the end of the day, don't forget to subscribe, guys. Since I keep posting fucking incredible videos which are gonna make some sense, keep following them. So hit subscribe. Bye for now. Last, don't forget to be a badass. Be a badass.